our class. Welcome to Thal Tutorials. Today we will be discussing the third part of the motion, and it is basically we will be discussing the three equations of the motions. Okay, so when we move forward, we see what is equation of motion by graphical method. When an object moves along a straight line with uniform acceleration, it is possible to relate its velocity, acceleration during motion, and the distance covered by it in a certain time interval by set of equations known as equation of motion. So basically there are three types of motion. There are three types of equation. First, v is equal to u plus at. Second is s is equal to ut plus half at square. And third is 2as is equal to v square minus u square. See, where v is the final velocity, u is the initial velocity, t is time, a is acceleration. See, equation 1 describes the velocity time relation. Equation 2 represents the position time relation, and equation 3, which represents the relation between the position and the velocity, is obtained from the first and second equation by eliminating t. These three equations can be derived by mathematical methods, but we will be doing basically on graphical method. So let us go to the first here. Now, what is equation for velocity time relation? Before going any further, we need to know, or we need to see the diagram. Consider this velocity time graph of an object that moves under uniform acceleration as shown in the figure. From this graph, you can see that initial velocity of the object is u at the point A, and then it goes and it increases to v at point B in time t. The velocity changes at a uniform rate A. See, in the figure, we can see the perpendicular line BC and BE are drawn from point B on the time and the velocity axis respectively. So, the velocity is represented by BC and the time interval is represented by OC. And with the graph, we can say BD is equal to BC minus CD, which represents the change in velocity in time interval t. If we draw AD parallel to OC, from the graph we observe that BC is equal to BD plus DC, or we can say as BD plus OA, both are same. So substituting BC as V and OA as U, we get V is equal to BD plus U. That is, BD is equal to V minus U. And we know what is the formula of acceleration, that is change in velocity by time taken, where acceleration is BD by AD. We can also write AD as OC, therefore BD by OC. Now, when we substitute OC by T, we get A is equal to BD by T. Or we can write BD is equal to AT. When we use equations, BD is equal to V minus U and we get V is equal to U plus AT. This is the first equation of motion. See, basically you will be getting numericals from this part, but it can come for 5 marks. Derived graphically, it can be any of the equation. This is the first equation which we discuss. This is V is equal to U plus AT. Now we'll come to the second equation. That is nothing, that is equation for position time relation. same graph we are using, let us consider that the object has a travel a distance of s in time under uniform acceleration a. In the figure, the distance traveled by object, as I have shown you in the second part, we find distance by finding the area. So distance, the object is obtained by the area enclosed within OA BC under the velocity time graph AB. So distance is equal to area of OA BC, which is a trapezium, or we can say rectangle plus triangle, area of rectangle OADC plus area of a triangle ABD. So that is equal to OA into OC, that area of rectangle, plus area of triangle, that is half into AD into BD, where OA we are substituting as U, OC we substitute as AD, and AD is equal to T. So BD is equal to AT. So we get the formula S is equal to, that is distance is equal to U, that is OA, OC is T, so U into T is equal to half, AD again T, and BD is equal to AT, so half AT. So S is equal to UT plus half AT square. This is the second equation of motion. Now we will come to third equation, that is equation for position velocity relation. In this equation, we see from the velocity time graph shown in the figure, the distance S traveled by the object in time t moving under uniform acceleration A is given by the area enclosed within the trapezium OABC under the graph. That is nothing, again distance is equal to area of the trapezium OABC, that we can write as OA plus BC into OC whole divided by 2. When we substitute OA is equal to U and BC is equal to V and OC is equal to T, we get S is equal to U plus V cos whole bracket into T divided by 2. Where T we all already know, that is V into U by A. V minus U by A. And when we are equating both the equations, we are getting S is equal to V plus U into V minus U by 2A. Therefore, 2AS is equal to V square minus U square. This was the third equation for the motions. We are having three equations. Again, I am telling you, first is V is equal to U plus AT. Second is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And third is 2AS is equal to V square minus U square. These are three equations. Now we will be discussing some numericals on that. First is a train starting from rest attains a velocity of 72 km per hour in 5 minutes. Assuming that the acceleration is uniform, we need to find acceleration and distance. Before going anything, we need to understand what are the information we have, because train was starting from rest, so whenever anything start from rest, that becomes zero, that speed or velocity becomes zero. So here U is equal to zero, that is initial velocity, and V is given as 72 km per hour, which we have converted into meter per second, that is 20 meter per second, and T is given as 5 minutes, again we convert into second, that is equal to 300 seconds. First, we need to find acceleration. So, what are the things we have? We have U, we have V, we have T. So, we know acceleration formula, that is final velocity minus initial velocity by time. That is 20 minus 0 by 300. That comes to 1 by 15 meter per second square. Now, second question. In the same thing is the distance traveled by the train for attaining this velocity. Again, we will use the equation, that is 2as v square minus u square. As I have already said to you, we will always use that equation through which we have all the information. So when we are using 2as is equal to v square minus u square, we are having all the things. We have found a, we have found v square, we know v, we know u. So when we are for solving this, so u is 0, so s is equal to v square by 2a. That is nothing, that is 20 square into divide by 2a. So 2 into acceleration is 1 by 15. We will be getting answer as 3000 meter or 3 kilometer. Thus, the acceleration of the train is 1 by 15 meter per second square, and the distance traveled is 3 kilometer. We'll go to the next question. What is the numerical? This question is little different. See here. The brakes applied to the car produces an acceleration of 6 meter per second square in the opposite direction. Opposite, whenever it is written, we use retardation, that is negative value of acceleration. So is given in the opposite direction to the motion. If the car takes 2 seconds to stop after the application of the brakes, we need to calculate the distance is traveling during this time. See, again I am telling you, we need to find what are the details given. So we have a is equal to minus 6 because of the opposite, t is equal to 2 seconds, and it is at going to stop, that is again going to rest, so v is equal to 0. So here we need to find distance. For before finding distance, we need to find u. Okay. The u is initial velocity. When you use the equation v is equal to u plus at, we will get the value of u, that will become 12 meter per second square. Now from there, we will use the formula s is equal to ut plus half at square. We have got the values of u. U is 12, t is 2, half at square, that is 12 we have already got. So when we solve, it will come to 12 meter. Thus, the car will move 12 meter before it stops after the applications of brakes. I think we are very through with the two examples which I have shared. The last topic which we are sharing is uniform circular motion. See, it is a specific type of motion in which an object travels in a circle with a constant speed. For example, any point of propeller spinning and constant rate is executing uniform circular motion. Other examples are second, minute, hour, hand of the watch. Okay. The change in velocity, which sometimes happens, is due to change in magnitude or direction of the motion. So what are the characteristics of uniform circular motion? Characteristic, it is a periodic motion with definite period and frequency. Speed of the particle are always remaining constant, but velocity can change continuously. It is an accelerated motion, and work done for uniform circular motion will be always zero. Why it will be zero? It will be zero because displacement is zero, and displacement is zero, so work automatically become zero. So this is the end of the topic for this PPT. In the last PPT, we will be discussing some numericals, and then an assessment will be taken, and hopefully we will see you passing with a great and good colors. Okay, thank you class, bye bye, good night, till we meet again.